convicted criminals making blankets for sick babies. It's a new program at Milwaukee County's House of Correction. WISN 12 News' Marianne Lyles goes behind bars where she discovered it's the female inmates gaining from the gifts they're making.
A plastic needle, some yarn. It's become Valerie Jernigan's therapy while locked up in the House of Correction.
With confinement comes with a lot of anxiety, depression, and being away from your family, a lot of that. And this helps.
She knows those feelings all too well, in and out of jail and prison for much of her adult life.
I'm really ashamed to say that, you know, I'm almost 50 and I'm still coming back and forth.
But no more shame for the theft and forgery crimes of her past. Now there's even a purpose leading other inmates. They now call her Mama Bear.
She's the very first one that I taught.
It's all because House of Correction Assistant Superintendent Carrie McKenzie came up with the idea of knitting.
You know, you have 70 inmates in a dorm with nothing to do. That just breeds tension. I was also made aware that that there were other correctional facilities that were doing projects such as this.
Plastic needles and yarn were donated.
It started with the inmates just learning how to knit. They learned how to create some blankets, and now some of them know how to create infant mittens and this hat.
But where would this all go?
I just suggested that maybe we could donate to Children's Hospital since it is such a great place.
Corrections Officer Sarah Moore remembered how her own daughter, Jordan, as a newborn, was in Children's Hospital. Brain malformation and heart failure.
They didn't know what was wrong with her for the first 3 days, so they just told me that she was going to pass away and there wasn't much they could do for her.
Jordan has had 6 successful brain surgeries. Today, she's a happy, healthy 5-year-old. But these women, especially Jernigan, understand there are more babies like her.
My sister, God rest her soul, she's deceased now. She was born with sickle cell anemia, and she was practically raised in Children's Hospital.
Comfort from behind bars.
I just feel wonderful being able to give something back after I've taken so much.
It gives them a sense of purpose and accomplishment.
They're so excited about it and so happy to do it. And then we hope that they carry it over into when they're not incarcerated anymore.
These women, many with babies of their own, but kept away because they've done wrong and now looking to do something right. In Franklin, Marianne Lyles, WISN 12 News.
They may need those blankets tomorrow. The inmates volunteer to take part in the program, and there's no cost to taxpayers. The Milwaukee County House of Correction is taking donations of yarn and plastic needles so that more inmates can learn to knit.